This is America. This used to be America.
It ain't no more, okay?
I know it ain't.
Well, Kelly's Court is back in session. On the docket today, the teacher behind what is being called an indoctrination video. Students in a Missouri classroom pledging their political support for the Democratic White House hopeful. Their teacher was just suspended for being behind this thing and for posting it on the internet for all to see, these young students. So, was it just an exercise of free speech, or was it a partisan use of your tax dollars? Let's ask our panel, Fox News legal analyst Mercedes Colwin and defense attorney Julie Moreau. Hello, ladies.
Good morning.
Hello, Megan.
All right, so tons of people, this thing has like gone crazy on the internet. Tons of people are watching it. Barack Obama had nothing to do with it. It was the teacher who was behind it, we're told, and the students who participated in it. Mercedes, was this school right to suspend this teacher, and they are considering legal action against the teacher?
Oh, absolutely. Where is any intellectual content to what he was teaching these students? Where is any discussion about the electoral process? What about the voting process? What about McCain? Sarah Palin being the first vice president, female vice presidential hopeful in the Republican Party? All of these things that could be said, this is educational, this is something to discuss, let's discuss it in a fair and balanced way. No, instead you have these kids in fatigues, no less, but doing these military-type techniques. What is this issue? I mean, it is obviously partisan, it's obviously outrageous, and certainly the school had every right to suspend the teacher.
Yeah, how about it? This is a charter school for 5th to 9th graders, Julia. Does a teacher have any right to ask students who were told are supposed to be studying reading and arithmetic during these hours to be doing this instead?
Megan, it is absolutely shocking and absurd that this teacher has been suspended. This charter school services a student population that is 95% minority. The mission statement of the school, among other things, is to teach them to celebrate their ethnic culture. So I ask you, what could possibly be wrong with teaching the African-American students about the policies of the first viable African-American presidential candidate, a candidate with whom they can relate, they can connect, who gives them hope, who invigorates their race? What's wrong with that? And under the law in Missouri, a teacher cannot be disciplined for exercising his or her First Amendment rights as long as the topic at issue is a matter of public concern. And political
candidates clearly matter of public concern. But Julia, a public school teacher cannot support a candidate in the classroom. They're not allowed to do that.
Under the law, that's their First Amendment right.
No, Julia, that's different. It's different. If you have someone that has that exercise.
Let Mercedes go, and then you'll go, Julia.
Sure.
Okay.
No, I mean, essentially this, what you're saying is your First Amendment right is unfettered. If you have these opinions, if you have these issues, if you have this belief, then you can go and have these your students ascribe to the same beliefs. That's not what the law says. You have the opinion, you have those opinions, you can express it, but you cannot impose it upon others. And that's what this teacher did. He can certainly do it. He can sit outside City Hall, for God's sakes, and be in a pulpit and say, this is who I support, this is my candidate. But to indoctrinate the kids, put them in fatigues, have them come in and do a military chant, that's not teaching what Obama is a role model.
Julia, how can you even defend this? Well, we don't even know if the students' parents consented to this. You assume that they support Barack Obama because he's black, but that's your assumption.
No, I'm not assuming that because he's black. I'm assuming that because I watched the video.
Well, you're the one who mentioned minority students.
That's right, but hold on. I watched that video, okay? Look at their faces. Listen to their voices. They are not simply parroting the ideology of a teacher. They can feel that. You can see that when you watch that video.
Oh,
they
Julia,
have opinions.
Come on. That is armchair psychology.
Too. We don't know that that teacher forced his or her ideas down those kids' throats. They wanted to do that. All the teacher did was provide them with a forum and enable
them
to get their message out.
Let me ask you this. How does this, okay, let's assume there are some McCain supporters among these young children. How do they feel when they are tasked with the assignment of getting up and singing Barack Obama's praises in the classroom?
That's certainly
There's no proof, Megan, that any of those kids in that video were McCain supporters.
Right, of course.
Okay, like, how do
we know? We
know probably
we
have no idea.
Have you watched them? Does anyone look like they're doing that against their
will? But is that beside the point? Is this not the very reason we don't allow politics in the classroom? Because you don't want students to be influenced one way or the other by teachers who have no business doing this with taxpayer dollars.
Where's the educational content? There is none. There is no educational content. You can look at this video and say, what in the world is this? Anybody looking at this would be outraged because there isn't any educational content to what they are saying. They're chanting infantiques. That's not an issue for a school setting.
No educational content. They're talking about the policies of Barack Obama. They clearly had to read and learn about the policies. They're talking about becoming engineers and lawyers and firemen.
And so you
talking
have to,
about
so,
having great careers ahead of them.
But they can do it without chanting Obama's name. They
can going on at school.
You know what? They can look around. This is the 21st century. There's lots of professionals of color in this century, and they certainly have lots of opportunities. They don't have to go and chant in fatigues to go and
until
say
November 5th,
Obama.
Until this thing is settled.
Exactly.
Gotta go, guys, because we're out of time. But very good debate. Julia, we appreciate it. And Mercedes, you as well.
Thank you.
Thanks so much,
one
baby.
Final word for our viewers. This school was absolutely right to suspend this teacher, and termination may also be in order here. Schools should be free from political indoctrination. The law is clear that public school teachers are not allowed to bring politics like this into the classroom. The American taxpayers don't want to pay for propaganda in the classroom for either side of the aisle.
That was fiery.
Yeah.
Man. Oh,
wow.